was victory.
Yeah.
But I also explained to DA that it was a team decision. And I asked the guys, I said, guys, like, what do you want to do?
Yeah.
We know how much Jamal means to this team. And DA didn't condone it at all. It's about the team. It's not about regrets. It's not about anything else. It's about us as a team making a collective decision. But I do apologize to Dennis. I apologize to DA because that was not his call.
Like, he's lost control of that locker room. But I'll say this. I would cut Jameis Winston today. I would not want him on my team. That's loser's mentality. And people will say, well, Shannon, what about when Dan Marino fake spiked the ball or Peyton Manning? They were not in victory formation. If you get down, the defense is conceding. If you want to run the ball, let the defense line up. Don't you fool them, think this a victory formation, and then drive off the ball. You mean to tell me that's going rogue?
So I worked for CBS this past weekend. And all the players, you know, come out, their family and friends. And Jameis Winston had like a really long crowd. Kept praying. I had it in my mind. Like, I waited like almost an hour. Walk up to Jameis Winston. What's his favorite Bible verse? You know, I finally just walk up to him. And I'm kind of nervous walking up to him. There's like 30 family members there. Taking all these pictures. He's like, all right. Like, his family's like, all right. Like, this is the last one. I talk to him like, yo, Jameis, what's up? What's your favorite Bible verse? He wasn't expecting that. Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him and he will make your path straight. Jameis, like, why is that your favorite verse? Jameis Winston blessed me in a way that I couldn't have thanked him for. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, because he mentioned that, like, he's been through so many trials and tribulations. And little did I know, he's telling me this, but he was literally kind of in the midst of one. I mean, he's under a lot of scrutiny right now. I did not know this when me and him were talking. Just had to do a press conference, having to like defend himself for his decision that he made. There's gonna be thoughts of doubt and worry and all these other things, and I don't want to like misquote him, but there's gonna be thoughts and doubts and worries when we're going through stuff. But we have to trust in the Lord, and we trust in the Lord by declaring his word over our life. And I said, wow. And I said, well, Jameis, like, I was honest. I said, Jameis, well, look, I struggle with my thoughts. He said, that's every time I have a thought like that, killing my flesh. Your flesh won't start running rampant in your life. Preach the whole message on killing your flesh for like five minutes in front of hundreds of fans. Jameis Winston is talking to me. Preach a legit message that blessed me so much, because he didn't know how much that meant to me. I don't think Jameis Winston gets like enough credit for like the man of God that he truly is. At the end of the conversation, if you ever see this video, man, I don't want to thank you from the bottom of my heart. You are truly a man of God, and I don't want to tell you that you are a light in this world, and I just pray that God bless you in all that you do. I pray that God blesses you in your career, your family, and I pray that whenever your playing career is over with, that God just expands your platform to heights that you can never imagine. I just want to thank you, brother. And Jameis Winston is the man, y'all.